As the government is in the process of formulating a new legal framework for the information and communication sector, female legislators under the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, UWOPA, have called for more regulations on media as far as gender-based violence is concerned, especially in promoting gender equality.
The existing laws make the gaps, but also other new laws that are coming in. So we also want to ensure that, the issue of gender equality is actually, it cuts across and should not just wait for, it should not be at the mercy of, whoever is making a decision.
Flavia Kabahenda Rabuhoro, the woman member of parliament of Chegegwa district and the chairperson of the parliamentary committee of gender, labor and social development, is concerned with the way the media mocks victims of sexual violence who need, instead of giving them sympathy and social support.
Victimizing someone who is already a victim. This girl has been raped. Every communication and language would be to sympathize and find solutions on mitigating further rapes and defilements and all that. And then what you hear on discussions on media, both from the media people themselves and also the public, because sometimes it's phone calls and everyone is punching holes at a person who is already stigmatized and victimized.
Kabahenda has also invited media managers to consider recruiting professionals who are responsible and accountable to the public.
To implore them to really be mindful of having people who are trained, skilled and professional in media, so that we can have media that is sanitized, media that is not going to be biased, media that is going to have a neutral language to communicate information.
Sarah Opendi, the chairperson of the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, wants the new law to address decency in the media. The legislator is concerned with the way media actors appear half-naked on air.
Hopefully, in the coming year 2024, we'll look at the existing laws, make the gaps, but also other new laws that are coming in.
Opendi is concerned that cases of sexual exploitation in the media are still rampant. She challenged the sector players to redeem themselves and resolve sanity in the media industry.
On the media managers, I mean, there's a lot of violence against women, sexual exploitation of some media person staff, and really mine is a call on you, because these people are vulnerable and of course they need the employment, but do not use your position to actually disadvantage them.
The Uganda Media Women's Association Executive Director Margaret Sentamu expressed the need by the government to amplify gender equality awareness campaigns and implementation of related laws in order to achieve gender equality in the media.
Aware that the Ministry of Labour and Social Development, maybe it is one of the least funded in this country. So to you, members of parliament, we think that it's very important to take note of that, so that we are not known for legislating or coming up with gender equality laws just for the sake of it. It is so important to commit and also implement. And implementation actually requires these finances.
The proposed bill seeks to repeal the Press and Journalists Act 1995, the Uganda Communications Act 2013, and other associated legislation such as the Computer Misuse Amendment Act 2022, among other laws, and consolidate them under one law titled the National Communications and Information Act. Report compiled by Fred Kajiwi for the news.